I'm kind of curious, but on the other hand, yeah, forget it. It can't beat a redhead, so let me see if I got any email. Two are unread. Email. Repaid favors. Don't touch the butter. From Mercurio. Stop by my apartment when you get a chance. I'll set you up. Okay, maybe he's got these new weapons we've been talking to. We've been mentioning to him. I doubt he has a tactical nuke. How about next? Don't touch the butter from Brock Foo at sillylittlepuppy.vtm. Don't touch the butter. That was a spam email. The new extreme sport that is sweeping the nation is now on a limited edition DVD. Watch supporters Iron Will McMahon, Brock Dry Hands Hines, and Margarine Mike Davenport as they use every bit of restraint in their body to not touch the butter. One bowl of butter, two contestants, three judges, and a hell of a lot of willpower. To order, log on to www.touchthebutter.vtm. Okay. Email for Suckhead. Beg your pardon.
Undiscovered family of sea creatures. A tourist bus destined for the ancient city of Angkor Wat that failed to return Wednesday night was found this morning, though without any trace of its operator or passengers. Cambodian officials have dispatched several military units into the area to search through the surrounding jungle amidst concerns that it is related to one of a number of Southeastern Asian terrorist organizations based in the region. Three American citizens are among the missing. Several dead at a beach house in Santa Monica tonight. Police suspect the slayings were carried out during a drug deal gone bad. Residents of this quiet community were shocked by the killings, though neighbors suspected the men in the house to be involved in drug distribution and had seen many strange people going inside at all hours of the night. Art criticism or vandalism? Paintings on display at Santa Monica's Gallery Noir were slashed by an intruder who evaded...
Yeah, I've heard this stuff.
Did you miss me? Judging by the way the boards lit up, I'd say you couldn't live without me. You make me feel so desirable, L.A. So many callers, so little time. If you don't get through to me tonight, don't let it break your heart. I'm here each and every a.m. So keep dialing those magic numbers and just maybe you'll be as lucky as this caller. What's your name, Night Owl?
Hello, Deb. This is Greg.
Hello, Greg. Up late, aren't we? Thank you, Greg.
Well, I imagine if you were half as pretty as your voice, then you're the prettiest woman in the city.
Aren't you the gentleman?
I imagine you a lot, Deb. Like I said, I'm all by myself, and it does get lonely.
Oh, jeez.
Sometimes a man can't help himself, especially when I hear you. It's like your hair.
Greg, there's a little thing called too much information.
Yeah, really.
Caller, you're whiling away the evening with the Deb of Night.
Good evening, Deb.
Yes, I think that's implied by the title of the show.
Do you ever worry, Deb, that the world is going to end?
I haven't felt that way since Brad Pitt got married.
Do you
Which time?
When they start devouring the world, you will be but a bloodstain on their capes.
I bet you say that to all the girls.
There is a red star in the night sky. The blood of mortals and the blood of ages all will be consumed. They are coming. These are the final nights.
Okay, well, good luck in the next election, sir.
Filing the Masquerade.
Apologies to all you night owls out there, but this girl's got something she's got to take care of for the next few minutes. Here's a little music to keep you up, if you get my meaning.
Phil's here. Gotta run. Great breakfast, honey.
Have a good day, dear. I'm glad you liked the muffins.
Hey,
well, she was playing
on
music.
The counter? That's not my margarine. That's butter.
It's...
Bitch! You know I'm supposed to watch my LDL levels.
What?
I thought it would be a nice change.
Oh my God.
I didn't even tell.
You don't want a divorce. You're trying to kill me. I'm glad I slept with your sister.
I thought it was margarine, grade B butter.
Nice.
Well, rancid taste of margarine with all the saturated fat of butter.
You are on fire, Bill.
I finally took your advice and you were right. I feel more confident than ever.
You the man. Isn't it great?
I couldn't even believe it. We went out to dinner and afterwards we started getting busy. I went into the bathroom to take it. I could feel it right away. Hell, you could see the tidal change in the toilet bowl.
The Visatrac. For an ordinary drug-enhanced erection, just isn't enough. Side effects include fainting, tingling in extremities, temporary blindness, deathly pallor, time perception distortions, aggravated bladder syndrome, emotional incest, pronounced incontinence, delusions of grandeur, and elevated risk of stroke.
Grandpa, will you take me to Space Burger?
Space Burger, huh? You know, when I was your age, space was mostly a mystery. We didn't know what was up there. Why, I thought there were little alien kids on Mars that might be watching me. Yeah, I used to make signs for them saying, "Hello, Martians!" Or, "Give me a ride on your rocket craft." Of course, I was young and naive, thinking Martians could read English. Everyone knew Martians communicated telepathically through space operators on their moon base.
Oh, yeah, everyone knows that.
What did I tell you about talking to Grandpa?
But I want to go to Space Burger.
Space Burger? This looks like a job for Commander Mom. Report to the space base.
Commander Mom?
Oh, boy. We can drop Grandpa off at the home on the way there.
Of course, you don't see Martians on space probes. Everyone knows Martians live in invisible domes.
Space Burger, food for the space age, not old age.
Last year, Democratic candidate Michael Redmond bought a sports utility vehicle. 3 months later, there were two separate incidences of hit and runs by an unidentified SUV in his area. Is Democratic candidate Michael Redmond to blame? Can you afford to take that chance? Can your children?
Vote Republican Senator Robert Thorne, a candidate that has never committed vehicular homicide. Democratic candidate Michael Redmond has never publicly stated his opinion on child pornography.
I think we heard that one.
Would you want a child pornographer voting on this nation's laws? Could you trust your children's future to someone like that? Vote Republican Senator Robert Thorne, the candidate that is committed to locking up child pornographers. Democratic candidate Michael Rebens recently sued Senator Robert Thorne for accusing Rebens of being a murderous child pornographer. Rebens had previously said he was against clogging up courts with frivolous lawsuits. Wouldn't this make him a hypocrite? Would you want a hypocrite as your next congressman? Would you want your children to become hypocrites?
Vote Republican Senator Robert Thorne, a candidate not accused of being a murderous child pornographer. Money troubles need cash quick. Why not try mugging someone? These are exactly the kind of questions the criminals are asking themselves right now. Did you know that the government requires you to wait 10 days for a gun? Why, in that time, a criminal could kill your family 50 times over. So how does a law-abiding citizen like yourself get a theft deterrent system in their hands in the next hour? Come to Loophole Lenny's. We've got antique military weaponry from blunderbusses to World War I grenades. Modern muggers may be stronger and faster than they used to be, but that doesn't mean they can take a slug fired by a Civil War era pistol any better. And if you're the kind of person that can't sleep at night knowing serial rapists might be in your front yard, we've got German sniper rifles approved by the Kaiser himself that'll make picking them off one by one from the safety of your roof no problem. Buy a weapon this month and we'll throw in an ammo belt with the Constitution printed on it free of charge. Loophole Lenny's, defending your tomorrow with the weapons of yesterday, today.
Ah, would you look at this?
What's that?
Plague of locusts descend on small Indian town.
Jeez, I can't imagine what that must be like.
And look at this. Civil war still raging between ethnic factions in Eastern Europe.
Yeah, heard about that.
And in Zimbabwe, they got to use ox carts for ambulances.
That's terrible. Hey, it's a good thing we live in the U.S.
It sure is, buddy. Hey, bartender, two more U.S. ales?
U.S. ale.
U.S. ale.
Welcome to the United States of Inebriation.
Did you miss me? Judging by the way the board's lit up, I'd say you couldn't live without me. You make me feel so desirable.
Yeah, repeating. U.S. United States of Inebriation. Well, Heather, make yourself at home. Oh, no.
I'm here each and every
you could sleep there. It doesn't look too... Yeah, move this thing. You can rest over there. Whoops. Pardon me, I'm a little clumsy. You can rest there, watch TV... Listen to the radio, you want to go on the internet, you know, I got all the amenities. You need to take a shower, you know, take a pee, you know, all that stuff, so. And there's pizza, you know, don't know if there's a microwave to heat it up, but cold pizza is a thing. Well, I got an oven, you know, just make sure you move this thing before you use the oven. Can I put that? Pardon me. Yeah, just put this here. Yeah. Enjoy, I'll be back soon.
Good evening, Deb.
She's so cute. She's like completely smitten with me. Does that always happen? Or was it just an added... She's infatuated on top of being a ghoul. So, I still gotta... It didn't drop me off here, right? No. Or did it? I don't know. Looking for my cab. I don't know where it is.
Hop in.
Yeah, okay, let's go. Well, I knew I'd run into her again at some point. Alright. Good. So I got two reasons to check in on my apartment. Now, I know he's right here. But... is Strauss this way or down the other road? That's the... he might be the other way. Oh, guys, straighten this place up. I can't move it off the street. No, he was the other way. Oh, Mercurio wanted to talk to me. Oh, damn it. It's a good thing I don't pay for the cab. Oh. This would be violating the Masquerade. That's like... inhuman stuff. You can't be doing that. I'll be back because I gotta talk to him. I'm just curious what he has. Not necessarily gonna be buying it just yet. Although I like the idea of having a sniper rifle. Let's wait. Here. I'll see if I can talk to Strauss, and I'm gonna go back. Because the cab is just gonna bring me back in front of Venture Tower, so.
Hello, Neonate. How can I be of assistance? Of course. What is it you would like to know?
What do you know about the Ankaran sarcophagus?
No more than yourself. But I do know that LaCroix is much too focused on acquiring it. His obvious need for it reveals a weakness that his enemies may one day exploit.
What do you think is inside of it?
I do not know, although I must admit that I sense a change in the night air, something subtle and not altogether pleasant. Perhaps the arrival of the sarcophagus is the harbinger of something more dreadful.
Like what?
I will say no more.
Ah, damn it.
What is it you would like to know? Of course. What is it you would like to know?
Nothing right now. Okay. I would like to give him all the information. But I don't have that option. Oh. Okay, I really would like to go... I Thank you. I wonder if we can ever get up here. I want to see if, I know it was just past there, too. I want to see if Venus has more money for me. You know what? Since I'm here, let's check in with these guys. I'm going to tell everybody but LaCroix.
So what'd you find out?
It was a slaughter. Whatever was in the sarcophagus killed everyone.
No kidding. Well, I guess there's gotta be something in there then, huh? The Camarilla's gonna be scraping for answers when this gets out.
You think it was an ancient then? You believe the legend?
It's in the air, all right. I've been around longer than most, kid. And I've felt the change in the past few decades. It's in the blood. We're racing towards something. And picking up speed all the time.
You should open an X file on this one. Yeah, I smell what you're cooking.
You've seen the evidence with your own eyes. You're caught up in all of this.
Yeah, I wish I knew where it was leading.
So, other than that, what else is new?
Still working for LaCroix.
Where are you headed now?
I don't know. I gotta go talk to LaCroix.
You do what you gotta do.
Okay.
What's up? Yeah? Yeah? Who do you want to know about? Yeah?
Check in with Damsel before I leave.
Sup? Yeah?
Nothing. Yeah.
2 minutes, newbie. All the time I've got to spare right now.
Oh, well, actually talk to me. Forgive me if I've been through this. It's been a while. Tell me about yourself.
Came to California to get out of the Dust Bowl during the 30s. Been fighting this fight since the 40s when we kicked out the cannon. I was new to it all back then. Not a whole lot of people from those nights still around. And some of them are. They're just not anarchs anymore.
Is it worth it? To have to constantly fight to keep LA?
That's a stupid question. Freedom doesn't come cheap. At any time, you gotta be ready to defend it. A lot of blood's been shed for what we have.
That's a stupid question, number one. You must have learned a lot in that time. Any advice?
Alright, this might help you out. I use guns, but most vamps get up close and personal. In that case, thing to do is to let them come in for the attack first, and dodge it or take it in the gut. Then use your blade to deliver the death blow. Time's up. Come around in a few nights if you're still alive. Maybe I'll have time to kill.
Stats increased? What was increased? Oh, he taught me about melee. Sweet. Can I read that book now? Let me just talk to him again.
Time's up.
Oh.
Come around in a few nights if you're still alive. Maybe I'll have time to kill.
So he's mostly just a trainer. A brawl ability of 2. Research skill of 2. Melee ability of 2.
But I doubt it.
I doubt it too, but what are you gonna do? So I gotta head back this way. I'm looking for... It looked like there was some bars missing from that, but it was just wasn't drawn in yet. I'll be back in a second. I gotta check in here, see if Venus has any money for me. That's the other thing I wanted to do. They said to come back in a couple of nights, but really...
Hey, Poppy, you need a date?
Is she wearing... Are those pants? Or is she just tan on her legs? And then less tan down here with the boots?
Hey there, need a date?
No, it looks like she's not wearing pants. That's fine by me. Just curious. Every time is nighttime. Actually, a watch would be a good thing. I think vampires gonna sense when night is coming. I mean, when dawn is coming. Yeah, get down. It's good.
Money, sucks, right? Bro. I've got your cut right here.
$125. Now I'll never forget this night. Thanks, Venus. Keep it coming.
This sucks, bro.
Getting $125? No, I'd say that does not suck. Alright. Childer is the plural form of child? This way. Best booty girl here. I think. Yeah. I know it seems like a stupid thing, but...
Going somewhere?
Just drive. I want to check in on Mercurio. Is no longer at the beach. Back at his apartment.
Haps, bro.
Apparently. The haps is me getting back to Mercurio. That's the haps. I was gonna turn around at that one particular spot.
Anything I can do for you tonight?
Equipment? That's it? You told me to come to your apartment.
Anything I can do for you tonight?
Maybe that email was before he met me at the beach and he just decided to intercept me since I had checked my email. In, some time.
Concerning? Who exactly? What's to tell? Anything I can do for you tonight?
Info.
Concerning?
Places?
Specifically?
Oh, never mind. I came back here all the way because I thought you had something for me. Alright, finally going to let LaCroix know what we found.
Hey,
I can't go through there, can I? No. We'll put these light poles there. I'm glad I still have these blood bags. I haven't needed to use them.
Where to?
Just drive. Drive that way. Drive safe.
Evening, Missy. You back to see Mr. LaCroix again?
Yep, that's right.
Yeah, he told me to send you up as soon as you came in. Lots of people here to see Mr. LaCroix. Nice guy. He seems a little different, though. You wonder if he's... that's his business.
How's it going, Chunk?
You know, I'm keeping the undesirables out and the innocent safe and secure. I'm the thin blue line that separates the crazies from the hard-working decent folks. Yep, as long as I'm around, Mr. LaCroix's got nothing to worry about.
Oh yeah, LaCroix is definitely innocent. His self-delusion is spectacular. I'm sure he appreciates that you're here to protect him. See ya, Chunk. I'm like, who's that? That's probably me.
I've said all I need to.
Oh, Strauss. Strauss? Who are these other people? Are they clan leaders?
One of my people was monitoring the police radio. Very sloppy. I stated explicitly that you are not to kill any police officers.
There's too many of them. They're in the
Their
way.
Deaths attract attention, and we have to generate spin to attach the blame to natural causes. I'm losing my patience. What did you see on the ship?
Losing your patience? I didn't know you were a doctor. Ha ha! Everyone on board was massacred. There weren't any survivors.
And the Ankaran sarcophagus? What did you see?
Didn't see much. There was blood all over the floor. Handprints indicate it was opened from within. I saw that much.
Opened? Let's not jump to conclusions. Give me the manifest in your notes. I'll sort this mess later. You might have noticed when you came in the parade of malingering mollycoddles filing out.
Clan leaders. To experience. I wonder if we had not killed a cop if we would have gotten more. What do you call it? Experience. Yeah. Who were they?
Those were the Primogen, this city's clan elders. A worrisome bunch devoted first and foremost to the security of their own skin. Which is why they were here. It seems Alistair Grout, the Malkavian Primogen, has either forgotten how to answer his phone, or is missing. The Sabbat's appearance has put the Primogen on edge. Grout's mansion is in the Hollywood Hills. I need you to pry Grout out of whatever crack he's crawled into and have him contact us.
Hollywood Hills. Cool. New area. Certainly. Is that all?
Yes. About Grout. As I said, Grout is the Malkavian Primogen. His behavior and home are eccentric, to say the least.
I'm sure.
He's developed a paranoid bent lately, so you may have to check under every bed in the place for him.
Okay. I have a few questions to ask before I go.
I suppose I can spare a few seconds.
I have some questions about people.
Yes.
The Primogen.
They are the representatives of their clans, though more often than not, they represent their own best interests. They stay close to power, but are too fearful of the consequences to wield it. Nonetheless, I seek their counsel on occasion.
So Strauss is a primogen and regent. Well, they're all regents as well. Someone else, or...
Yes.
Something else?
Which is...
Never mind. I'm ready to go see Grout.
When we hear from Grout, you may come back. Until then.
Okay, goodbye. When you hear from him, so...
The primogen hate to be kept waiting. And they let me know that frequently. When we hear from Grout, you...
Cut off. So in other words, yeah. Once I let Grout... Once I have Grout contact... them... Then I can come back here. So we've got a new Aeros then. Which of course we're going to be taking the cab. The Prince wishes you to contact Alistair Grout, the Malkavian primogen. You should try looking for him at his mansion on the outskirts of town. It says downtown. Well, I guess... Alright. What I'm guessing is you get into the cab, and then you can go to Hollywood. Yeah. So, I'll leave that for next episode. Exciting, new area, sweet! Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.